Good morning, student. Last time we see a dissection of maize, but the title of this exercise is maize and coconut, dissection of maize and coconut. But due to the limitation of time, I am not able to cover dissection of coconut in the session of last practical. So I have included dissection of coconut flower here in this exercise, that is emasculation and hybridization techniques in sorghum and coconut. So common name is sorghum, botanical name is sorghum bicolor, family graminea, chromosome number 2n is equal to 14. Mode of pollination is often cross pollination. For what we said, the definition of often cross pollination is that the plant in which the extent of cross pollination ranges from 5% to 30%, then this type of pollination is called as a often cross pollination, and the crop sorghum is often cross pollinated. Why the sorghum is often cross pollinated? Because whatever the viability of pollen grains of own flower is there, this viability of pollen grains is so less as compared to that of viability of gynoecium. So the mode of pollination or the type of pollination in sorghum is often cross pollinated. The inflorescence, whatever the inflorescence is there, that inflorescence, whole inflorescence is called as head or the ear in case of sorghum, and the inflorescence having a pedicel, that is called as a peduncle, and whatever the first leaf is there from which that head or the ear is emerging from that leaf is called as a flag leaf. So the first leaf which is first from that from the top is called as a flag leaf, and the it is also called as a the sheath enclosing flag leaf is called as a flag leaf sheath there. Then these are the types of inflorescences. In case of sorghum, there is a two type of inflorescences are there. First one is a compact type inflorescence and the loose type inflorescence. If you see a fodder sorghum, then in that fodder sorghum, whatever the branches of the head there, these are the loosely arranged, or the they are having a more space in the branchlets. So this type of inflorescence is called as loose type of inflorescence, and when whatever the branches of the panicle is there, they are closely arranged, then this type of a panicle is called as a compact ear head. Okay, then the spikelet, the whatever the spikelets are there, these spikelets are arranged. This whole structure is called as a pair of spikelet, and these spikelets always arrange in a pair. Okay, out of which one having a one is broad in length and one is narrow in length. Okay, and out of which the pair of spikelet out of which one spikelet having a pedicel and one spikelet does not bear pedicel, so it is called as a sessile spikelet. The portion of this is the part of rachyle is there, it is not pedicel of that sessile spikelet. So the pair of spikelet is there, out of which one is a pedicelate and narrow one, it is called as a pedicelate spikelet, and one is broad and without pedicel is called as a sessile spikelet. The sessile spikelet is a bisexual, and the whatever the pedicelate spikelet is there, it is a unisexual, or the it is a staminate floret. Okay, only stamens are present there, gynoecium is absent in a staminate floret, but in sessile floret both the androecium and gynoecium is present there, so it is a perfect spikelet. Then the pedicelate spikelet, which is narrow, and the staminate one, and the sessile spikelet is broad and fertile one. Okay, here is correction is there, narrow and staminate one, and sessile spikelet is broad and fertile, and it is also a bisexual floret is there. Then this is the structure of sessile spikelet, because the sessile spikelet having a how many parts? The sessile spikelet having the outermost covering is the outer gloom, then exactly opposite to the outer gloom there is a presence of inner gloom, then avon lemma is there, that hairy structure that we see on a ear head of jawar, that is avon lemma. Then after avon lemma, the pallea is there. Inside the pallea, androecium, gynoecium is enclosed, and at the base of androecium there are the two lodicules. Then what are the function of lodicule? That pushes anther at the time of pollination, it absorbs water and gets swollen, and it pushes anther outside the spikelet. That is the function of lodicule. So these are the parts of sessile spikelet. So if you see here, the first one whorl is there, that is called as a outer gloom. Then inner gloom is there. Then whatever the that hairy structure with papery structure is present inside, that is called as a avon lemma. After that avon lemma, there is a presence of a papery and transparent structure is there, that is called as a pallea. And inside the pallea, there is a three stamens, three anthers, and bifidary stigma is present. This is the gynoecium and androecium. So this is the bisexual flower, and this is the diagram of glumes. The first one is outer gloom, then this one is a inner gloom, which is exactly opposite to that of outer gloom. Then after outer gloom, there is a avon lemma is there. Okay, after avon lemma, there is a presence of pallea is there. After pallea, there is androecium and gynoecium are present, and ovary at the base of that bifurcated bifidary stigma, and the triangular two lodicules, means one pair of lodicule, is present in a swargam. So if you observe one spikelet, then whatever the broad one is there, that that is a fertile spikelet, and whatever the staminate spikelet is there, that one is a sterile one. Whatever the anthers are present, so this one is the corrected here. So I made a correction here. So whatever the narrow spikelet is there, that narrow spikelet having a sterile stamens there. So though it is a staminate one, but whatever the stamens present there, these are the sterile one. And in broad, in sessile floret, whatever the anthers are there, these anthers are fertile one. So this is the bisexual perfect spikelet, and the anthers of this spikelet, sessile spikelets, are the fertile one. So this is the structure. Here the this one is the outer gloom, then exactly opposite to it, it is the inner gloom. After inner gloom, there is a avon lemma is present, and inside the avon lemma, the structure is present, the papery structure is present, it is called as a pallea. And inside the pallea, there is a presence of three anthers and gynoecium. So androceums are three numbers, gynoecium is bifurcated feathery. This is important for your objective point of view, that the structure of stigma in case of sorghum is bifurcated feathery, brush like stigma present in case of sorghum. So this is the bifurcated. If you at the time of dissection, it is very well seen by you that the stigma is bifurcated, means having this such type of structure, and it is having a feather like structure. Okay, so the stigma is bifeathery, bifurcated, anthers are three in numbers, then these are the lodicules, then this is the pallea, then this one is the avon lemma, then it is inner gloom, and the outermost covering is the outer gloom. So this is the bifeathery, bifurcated feathery stigma, and the what is the function of that lodicule? It pushes the anthers at the time of pollination. So this is the function of lodicule here. Okay, the mode of pollination in case of sorghum is often cross pollinated. Then this is the emasculation and pollination. So hand emasculation is also present there. For that, we have to remove some of the branches of that ear, and then we have to open up each sessile spikelet with the help of needle and remove the three number of anthers. So each inflorescence or the each ear for emasculation requires one whole day. okay, then bag it after emasculating each and every floret, then bag it with a brown paper bag. And for pollination purpose, firstly wear a brown paper bag on male parent and then shake it on a hand, so that whatever the anthers pollen grains are collected in that brown paper bag, and then remove this brown paper bag and again wear this brown paper bag on a emasculated ear head, and again do a shaking, due to which whatever the pollen powder collected from that male parent will be dusted on that emasculated gynoecium. In that way the emasculation, hand emasculation, is done in case of sorghum. Then there is another method also present in case of sorghum, that the name of method is the plastic bag method. Here are three methods are present in case of sorghum. First one is hand emasculation, then plastic bag method. In that method, what is done there, after emergence of ear, the plastic bag is wear on that ear head and then it is tied with a thread. Due to the humidity which is created in that plastic bag, due to which the anthers are come out from that sessile spikelets, but that anthers do not get brushed. Only they get, come out from that spikelet, but it does not brush due to the high humidity inside that plastic bag. And after emerging of that anthers does not dehiscence, that does not produces pollen grains there. Only they emerge out from that spikelet. After emerging of that anthers from that spikelet, then gently jerks these whatever the ear head inside the that polythene sheet, and due to which the anthers get loose from that spikelet, get broken from that spikelet, and after that then it shedding of that anthers from that spikelet, then remove this polythene sheet and then we get the emasculated ear head here. So the main reason which is behind of that emasculation is that after tying a polythene sheet on a ear head, the humidity is maintained there, and due to that humidity the anthers get mature, but the pollen powder or the dehiscence of anther does not happen there, and in that way we can do a dissection of sorghum ear head, and then pollinate this emasculated ear head with a proper pollen donor male parent, and in that way you can do a dissection, you can do a emasculation and hybridization in sorghum. Then third method is emasculation of sorghum by hot water method. As the pollen grains of sorghum are sensitive to as the anthers of sorghum are sensitive to the 47 degrees Celsius, and it get inviable or it get dyed when we dip a ear head in a hot water thermos for 10 minutes. In that way also you can do a dissection. Simply you take a thermos flask in which 47 degrees Celsius of water, and then insert a ear head into that thermos flask for a 10 minutes. In that way whatever the anthers are there in that ear head get dyed or get inviable, and we get a emasculated ear head there, and then do a proper pollination with a proper pollen donor parent there, and in that way you can do a dissection, you can do a emasculation and hybridization in case of sorghum. So these are the three methods. First one is the hand emasculation, then plastic bag method, and third one is the emasculation of sorghum by hot water method. This is important for your 4 marks question in practical examination, so you should take care or you should note down this question in your notebook. Then this is the assignment for you: do a dissection of sorghum flower, then mount different parts in a sequence on mounting sheet and draw a proper diagram of floral biology of sorghum. So this is the chart for your reference to draw a diagram. So you have to write this all information on a blank paper and then insert this blank paper in a file, and this is the named this type of the dissection you have to do there. First one is the outer glume, inner glume, lemma, pallea, lodicules, androecium, gynoecium. Then sessile florate you have to stick there, then the pedicellate florate, and you can paste here a pair of spikelet also here. So these are the dissected parts of sorghum. These are the lodicule, bifidary, bifurcated stigma, three anthers, two lodicules, pallea, oven lemma. How to identify lemma? That is the hairy structure which is attached to the papery structure, that is the oven lemma there, and this one is the outer glume, inner glume. So this is the assignment for you. You do a practice of dissection of sorghum, and for dissection purpose for you have to select a immature ear head there. So the grain should not be formed there in that ear head. So you should select a immature ear head for the purpose of dissection there. So this is the appropriate stage for ear for the dissection purpose. This one is the fodder. This is the ear head of the fodder jawar, and this is the ear head of crop jawar there. So this stage of this is the ear head which is recently come out from that flag leaf. You should select immature ear head for your dissection purpose. The over mature ear head should not be selected for your dissection purpose. Okay, so this is the appropriate stage of your selection of ear head. Thank you. Good morning, student. Today we are going to start lecture dissection of sorghum, that is sorghum bicolor, and the different parts of sorghum I have arranged here for your easy understanding. The first one part for a dissection, you should select a immature head of the sorghum. This the appearance of the head is as like that. No anther should be come out from that spikelet, and it will be help you to see to do the dissection of different parts of sorghum spikelet. So this one is the small portion of the head of sorghum. So here this lining or these branches is called as a rachis, and on that rachis the spikelets are arising in a pair. Okay, so if you see a single spikelet here, in that single spikelet if you see here, one spikelet is a pedicellate one. One spikelet is with pedicel, so it is called as a pedicellate one, and one is directly arising on that rachis and without the pedicel, so this one is a broad one, so this is called as sessile spikelet. So in sorghum there is a two spikelets are there. One is a pedicellate one, which one is a narrow one, and another one is a broad, which is a sessile. Sessile means which is without pedicel, so this is called as a sessile spikelet. In case of sorghum, this broad spikelet is a fertile one or the perfect one, and the narrow and the which one is the pedicellate one is the narrow one is the staminate, and the anthers are not fertile there. So we are only interested in to do the dissection of sessile spikelet. So you should remember that the broad sessile spikelet in case of sorghum is the perfect florate, and this one is the fertile florate, and the narrow pedicellate spikelet is of the sterile nature. There is no use in case of the pollination. So we will start a dissection of sorghum florate here. Here you can easily observe that the one florate is with pedicel. This one is called as a pedicellate spikelet, and the broad one is called as perfect one or the fertile one spikelet. Okay, so in each rachis, the spikelets are arranged in the pair. One is a pedicellate one and one is sessile one. Sessile one means the florate which is without pedicel is called as a sessile florate, and the florate with pedicel is called as a pedicellate one. But in case of sorghum, the pedicellate florate is not fertile, and the sessile florate is a fertile one. So we want to do the dissection of only the sessile florate here. So these are the different parts that we have to dissect from that sessile florate. First one, the outermost covering of the sessile florate is the outer glume. Inside the outer glume there is a inner glume. After inner glume there is avant lemma is present. The lemma is with avant. Okay, that hairy appearance get attached to the lemma, that is called as a avant lemma. And inside the lemma there is a presence of palea, and in palea there is a three anthers, and the bifidary stigma is present. So this is the general dissection of the sorghum florate. First one is the outer glume, inner glume, avant lemma, palea, then three anthers and the bifidary stigma. As in the maize, we see that in the maize the four lodicules are present, but in case of sorghum only two lodicules are present, which are at the base of the anthers. And the function of lodicule is that lodicules absorb the water and get swollen, and that pushes the anther at the time of pollination. So the main function, it plays the important role in the fertilization process because it pushes anthers outside the florate for the purpose of pollination at the time of maturity. So these lodicules get swollen and it pushes the anther outside the florate. The mode of pollination in case of sorghum is the often cross pollinated crop. So the mode of pollination is often cross pollination, because up to the 30% pollination in case of sorghum is happened by a cross pollination. So it is often cross pollinated crop. There is a less chances of self pollination there. Now we start the dissection of sorghum florate. For dissection purpose, we have to select the immature, means the head which is coming out from that flag leaf. That ear head should be selected to do the dissection of the sorghum. Then from which I have taken a small part of ear head, and out of that ear head I am only selected here one sessile florate, and by removing pedicellate florate. Now the first step is of the dissection is that if the fodder sorghum is available, then you can use the fodder sorghum for the dissection purpose also. The outermost covering, firstly remove the outermost covering. It is called as the outer glume. Then remove it. This one is outer glume. After outer glume, opposite to the outer glume, there is a presence of inner glume. Then remove inner glume also. Then avant lemma. The avant get attached to which part, that is called as avant lemma. This one is award lemma. Then remove it with the help of forceps or needle. Care should be taken that it should not be broken. The one should not be broken from that lemma. And exactly opposite to that, there is a presence of talia. Then remove this palia, and inside the palia there is a presence of three anthers and one gynoecium. So bifidary stigma is here. See, bifidary stigma. Then this one is outer glume, then inner glume, then this one is called as a avon lemma, and then this one is a palia. Then we have to remove lodicules. So lodicules is present at the base of that anthers, which one is a triangular one. So remove these two lodicules from the base. So I have removed lodicules from the base of that anthers. The lodicules are two in number. Very nice. So arrange these triangular lodicules here. One pair of lodicules is present in sorghum and two pairs of lodicules present in maize, and absence of lodicules in case of bajra. Okay, now arrange anthers above lodicules. Now our parts, dissected parts, are ready to paste. So this is dissection of sorghum. Again, I am showing you to how to do the dissection of sorghum. It is too much easy to dissect out. Only one small part, that is the lodicules, which are attached to the base of that pedicel, to that rachis at the base of anthers. So again, I am showing you while taking sessile florate, you should take some rachis with it, because it will help you to handle this florate. Now remove the sterile florate, which is pedicillate one, and in case of sorghum, the sessile florate is a fertile one. Okay, so first step is that firstly, gently with the help of needle, remove outer glume, this one is outer glume. Then opposite to that there is a presence of inner glume. Okay, this is inner glume, which I have folded in both the fingers. I am only showing you a procedure how to dissect. Then with the help of one, you can easily identify lemma here, avon. The lemma is with avon, and opposite to that lemma there is a presence of that palia. See here, palia is present here. Okay, this one is a palia and this one is avon lemma. Okay, So remove that palea and lemma, avon lemma, and at the center there is a presence of three anthers with bifidary stigma. So three anthers, and there is a presence of very nice three anthers, and this one is bifidary bifurcated stigma, presence of bifidary bifurcated stigma, and lodicules are also there. These two are lodicules, and check out at the base if there is any lodicule is remaining. Okay, so in that way you can do a dissection of sorghum flower. And another one method is that you can simply press out while dissecting sessile florate. We are removing that pedicellate florate which are present at the base of that sessile florate. Okay, this pedicellate florate should be removed at the time of dissection, and only do a dissection of sessile florate which one is a broad one. Okay, and another method of doing a dissection in case of sorghum is that only press out with the help of, as like in this method is also followed in case of bajra also, only press out the press out the florate in point finger and thumb finger from the base, then it will help to remove that outer gloom will remain with here, then inner gloom, then this one is a palea, and this one is a lemma, and this one is a gynoecium, and three anthers, and at the base of that outer gloom there is a presence of two lodicules. So here are two lodicules. So by both method you can do a dissection of the flower. Okay, so one by one you can open a flower, or another method is that you can simply press a florate and do a dissection. See here, only press okay. So in another method, in pressing method, what happened, there may be a damage to the gynoecium, because gynoecium is the delicate part of that flower, and it should be removed with the while coming out anthers. So other parts get removed very easily by a second method. Okay, so in that way you can do a dissection also, or by one by one removing outer gloom, inner gloom, lemma, palea, then gynoecium. In that way also you can do a dissection of the sorghum florate. Okay, so again I am trying to show you a press method. Wow, so nice. See, three anthers, then bifidary stigma is also coming out from that with these three anthers. Then this one is outer glume. Outer glume, opposite, exactly opposite to the outer glume, there is a presence of inner glume. Then the innermost portion, this one is avon lemma, and inside the avon lemma there is a presence of pallia. This one is avon lemma and this one is pallia. Wow, very nice. Outer glume, inner glume, then avon lemma, pallia, then three anthers, and this one is a bifurcated stigma, and at the base of their rachis there is a presence of two lodicules. Okay, in that way you can do a dissection, or by opening one by one also you can do a dissection of Bajra flower, sorghum flower. So by first method, while opening flower, the tear should be taken. That firstly you should identify a lining, okay, lining of the outer glume. Okay, this one is the lining of the outer glume, then remove it properly. Then exactly opposite to that outer glume there is a presence of inner glume. Then in the same way you should see the lining of the inner glume and then fold it properly or remove it properly. Okay, in that way also you can do a dissection of the sorghum flower, either by one method or either by pressing a floret in with the help of forceps, hold a floret in thumb finger and point finger, and then press the floret from base to top with the help of forceps. Thank you. Now we are going to start dissection of coconut. Common name is coconut, botanical name Coccus nucifera. Chromosome number of coconut is 32. Family Arecaceae. Mode of pollination in a case of coconut is a cross pollination, and the reason for the cross pollination is the monoecious condition. That is, what is meant by monoecious condition? That is, male and female flowers present in same inflorescence but at different location. In a diagram you can see here very well, that is whatever the male and female flowers present in that inflorescence, they are separate male and female flowers present in the same inflorescence. So how to identify the male flowers and female flowers or the staminate flowers in case of coconut in the same inflorescence? So if you see a globular structure, that globular structure always indication of the ovule there, and this is the female flower in case of coconut inflorescence. And what is the triangular or the small size flowers are there, and these are the staminate flowers, and the staminate flowers are more in number than that of the pistillate flower or the female flower. So this is the indication by which we can identify the male and female flowers in case of coconut plant. So the condition which is responsible for the cross pollination in coconut is the monoecious nature, that is male and female flowers present in the same inflorescence but at different locations. So the condition of calyx, whatever the calyx are there, the calyx in case of male flower, now this is the case I have separated here because we are only interested to do a dissection of male flower here, staminate flower here, only we have to do a dissection of staminate flowers. So the calyx present in the male flowers, the calyx are three in numbers, and the condition they are free from each other, the sepals are free from each other. So the condition of calyx is polysepalous condition. And the corolla, the three numbers of corolla, the three numbers of petals present in the staminate flower, and they are free from each other. So the condition of corolla is polypetalous condition, and they are somewhat hardy in nature. Okay, so this is the staminate flower. We see here the three petals are present in case of staminate flower, and each petal enclosing two stamens there. Okay, so three petals are present in case of staminate flower, and each petal consisting of two stamens there. So the number of petals present in the staminate floret is three, and number of stamens present in the staminate floret is six. You can see here six number of stamens present in case of staminate floret. Okay, so each petal consisting of two stamens there. Okay, so this is the structure of staminate flower. Then the androceums are six stamens which are enclosed in the three petals, as I earlier told you that. And the gynoecium, in case of females, the gynoecium is also having a three lobed gynoecium is present there. Three lobes of the gynoeciums are present in case of female flowers. If you see here the three lobes, this is the female flower, this is the female flowers, and three lobes are present here at the top of that globular structure. So the three lobed gynoecium present in case of gynoeciums, and the female flower does not open at all. The pollination happens at a three lobes, the three lobes gynoeceum, stigma of that gynoeceum, and in that way the pollination happened there. And this is the staminate floret there, and staminate floret having a three stamen, three petals, and three sepals, and six stamens are present there, and each two of the stamens enclosed in a single petal. Okay, so this is the structure of androecium and gynoecium in case of coconut plant. So how to identify male and female flowers? Whatever the globular structure which are appeared in the inflorescence, that globular structure will be a female flower, and other rest of them, rest of the flowers are the male flowers in case of coconut. So the whole inflorescence, we always see these two structure in the coconut plant. First one is the inflorescence, and whatever the inflorescence is there, it is called as a spadix, and that spadix structure is enclosed in a boat shaped woody structure. Whatever the boat shaped woody structure is there, in which the inflorescence, in which the spadix get enclosed, that structure is called as a spath. Okay, so the inflorescence of coconut is called as a spadix. This is important for your examination. The inflorescence of coconut is called as a spadix, and the spadix enclosed in a woody boat shaped structure is called as spath. Okay, so this is important for your examination. Then how to do a dissection, and how to do emasculation and hybridization in coconut. Firstly, the whatever the globular structures are there, these are the female flowers. So the motto is that we have to emasculate the staminate flower. We have to remove the staminate flower from that inflorescence. So remove all the staminate flowers of that spadix. Only there will be a female flowers there, and this is the emasculated inflorescence of the coconut there. Then as the staminate flowers are the hardy in structure, so remove all the staminate florets, and then with the help of rod it should be rolled, due to which the pollen will be immersed from that staminate flowers. The pollen powder will be good quality pollen powder we will get there, and then that pollen powder will be pollinated on that emasculated floret there. And after pollination, immediately the bagging is done there, and after that in that way we get a fruit set, the hybridized fruit set in case of coconut there. So this is the assignment for you. Do a dissection of coconut male flower. Mount different parts in sequence on mounting sheet. After drying, dissection, enclose in a polythene sheet and write down common name, botanical name, chromosome number and family on that mounting sheet. So in that way you have to do a dissection. These are the six number of stamens there. This is the staminate floret and we have to do a dissection of that staminate floret. And these are the three petals are there and these are the three calyx are there. So the condition of calyx is polysepalous, polypetalous, androecium and gynoecium is absent in the staminate floret. So in that way the emasculation and hybridization is done. In single inflorescence, whatever the staminate florets are there, we have to remove it. Then only there will be a female flowers in that inflorescence. Then bag it with a polythene sheet because we have to avoid the entry of the pollen grains. Then extraction of pollen grain is done from desired male parent, and after that uncover that bagged inflorescence and do a dusting of pollen grains in that emasculated female inflorescence, and then there will be a seed set that fruit are the hybrid fruits that we do a hybridization of the coconut plant. So do a dissection of sorghum and the staminate flower of coconut. So you should find a short height coconut plant on which the flowering is there, on which the inflorescence is there, and then take out one staminate flower there and do a dissection of the same flower. Good morning student, today we are going to start dissection of coconut flower. This is the inflorescence of coconut flower. So whatever the main axis is present, the inflorescence of coconut flower is called as spadix. So this is the spadix which I have cut, and the this one is the main axis. This is the central axis. It is also called as a central axis, and whatever the branches of that central axis is there, that is called as a rachis. Okay, and on this rachis, whatever the male and female flowers, these male and female flowers are arranged in crisscross in zigzag manner. So this one is called as a rachis, and whatever the sub branch of rachis is there, that is called as a rachidi. Okay, so the mode of pollination in case of coconut is a cross pollination. Then what is the reason that the mode of pollination in coconut is a cross pollinated? Because whatever the coconut flower is a monoecious one. So whatever the male and female flowers are there, these male and female flowers present at a two location in the same inflorescence. Okay, so this is the inflorescence of coconut is called as a spadix, and this spadix is covered in a boat shaped structure is called as spathic. Okay, this is important for your objective point of view. So in inflorescence, whatever the terminal flowers are there, these terminal flowers are male flowers. These flowers are staminate flowers. The gynoecium is absent in these flowers. And the female flower, how to identify the female flowers in coconut? So the whatever the circular flower arising on that rachis, these circular flowers is called as a pistillate flower, or it is called as a female flower. Okay, so these flowers, the stamens will pollinate this pistillate flower or the female flower, and that will give the coconut plant. Okay, so this is the general structure of the inflorescence of coconut flower. So many more male flowers are present than that of the female flower. So how to identify the female flower? We are only going to do a dissection of staminate flower. We are not doing a dissection of female flower, because this one is somewhat tough one, and the condition of the flower is closed one. So when you take a more immature flowers, female flower in that, then a three lobe gynoecium will you see at the top of that circular portion, and that that gynoecium get pollinated by the pollen grains of the staminate flower, and it gives a coconut fruit. So more and more staminate flowers are present, and after pollination that staminate flower will get fall down, and only the female flowers will with the fruit remain on that spadix. Okay, so now we will do a dissection of staminate flower. For staminate flower, you can select a flower with that position of this position, simply somewhat opening position, and it having a three petals, and these three petals, each three petal encloses two anthers. So number of petals in staminate flower is three, and each petal there is a presence of two stamens there. So the number of total androecium or number of stamens present in the staminate flower is six, and three petals are there. The petals are somewhat hard, so remove it. Then the portion at below there is a three calyx is also present, and this calyx, the condition of calyx is free from each other. So the calyx condition in case of coconut is polysepalous condition. So remove calyx. It is same that of the petal color. So the condition of calyx in case of coconut is polysepalous condition. Then remove petals. In each petal, it encloses two anthers. See here. In each petal, it encloses two anthers. Okay. So, number of anthers present in coconut is six. If stigma is present, then it is a non-functional or non-functional one. So these are the three anthers. These are the six anthers which are enclosed in three petals. So this is the structure of staminal floret. While removing androecium, you should remove it with a filament. And these are the six number of anthers, and this is calyx. The calyx is in the free from each other, so the condition of calyx is polysepalous condition, and the condition of petals also polypetalous condition. It is somewhat hard, so it will not be stick properly, but try to stick it well. So these parts are petals also free from each other, so the condition of petal also called as polypetalous condition. Okay. And these are the androeciums. Once you understand the floral biology of any flower, then there is no need to remember the mode of pollination. The mode of pollination in case of coconut is cross pollinated because the condition is monoecious. The male and female flowers present in same plant body but at different locations. So the mode of pollination in case of coconut is a cross pollination. And how to identify a female flower on spadix? If you see this circular ovary, these flowers is called as a female flowers. Those flowers which bears coconut, these flowers is called as spadix. This flower is called as a female flowers. Now I am cutting this female flower for our identification. Which type of structure is enclosed in that? This is fertilized ovule here. The condition of female flower is in closed condition. Only you have to do the dissection of staminate flower. Okay. So this type of three lobed gynoecium is present. These are the three lobes. This one. Okay, this one is gynoecium, so nice. Okay, so such type of three lobe structure present in case of, see here, so nice. Such type of three lobe gynoecium present in case of coconut. If you see here, there is a three lobes present, and here the pollination takes place by a staminate flower, and it will lead to the formation of coconut. So this is the dissection of coconut flower. Only you have to do the dissection of staminate flower. Thank you.